In Japan, the bright lights never stop burning. The nation has an insatiable need for energy, but virtually no natural resources to generate it. To meet demand here, they bet big on nuclear power.
We blindly believe nuclear plants were completely safe, immune from accidents, and the cheapest source of energy.
But the meltdowns at Fukushima Daiichi changed everything.
To avoid another Fukushima, we should close all nuclear plants.
Like the rest of the world, Japan is at a crossroads.
Can they get along without nuclear? Sure. The price is going to be very, very high for them. Wind and solar are not going to run the Ginza lights.
How will we power the planet without wrecking the climate?
If you really do wish to do something about climate change, nuclear is the path.
We don't use nuclear because we got freaked out in the 70s.
There are some innovative ideas on the drawing boards.
For my generation, we are much more concerned about climate change and global warming. We're not going to rule anything out because the issue is so important.
But given its checkered past, how realistic is atomic power? Are we ready for the nuclear option? Right now on Nova.
Breaking news, a violent earthquake off Japan's northeast coast has rocked.
A 7.9 earthquake in Japan.
It began with an epic earthquake at sea. Which spawned a giant tsunami. A 45-foot high wall of water. It rolled over the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant, triggering a cascade of failures. Three hydrogen gas explosions. Three meltdowns. The uncontrolled release of radioactivity into the ocean and into the air. It contaminated a huge swath of land, prompting the evacuation of more than 100,000 people in a 12-mile radius. The worst affected areas, northwest of the plant, remain off limits, abandoned. No one will be able to live here for a very long time.
Through the plant, it gets mixed in with the contaminated water that is.
It's now been nearly 6 years since the meltdowns at Fukushima. I've been reporting on this since it happened. Six trips in as many years. I've traveled up and down the desolate evacuation zone.
We are about a kilometer from the Fukushima Daiichi plant, getting particularly high readings here, 34 microsieverts per hour.
Victims who lost so much in the earthquake and tsunami in limbo, unsure when or if they can return home.
I lost three family members, my mother, my wife, and my oldest son.
I thought if we fixed the house, we could return here to live. I thought that when we left. But now that I see it, there's no way. No way.
And many are understandably opposed to nuclear power.